What's up, everyone? Neocyther here, getting back to Silent Hill Homecoming. And before we get too far into this, I realized I kind of forgot something about survival horror games, and that is, don't be afraid to explore. I say this because while I'm not using a guide to get me through the game unless I'm really stuck, I have been watching, or not really watching, but just kind of skipping through another YouTuber's playthrough to kind of gauge where I'm at in the game. And in doing so, I realized I forgot to check out an area that I was literally right next to. I don't know why I didn't. And in that area is a bunch of lore for the game, I guess, as well as a very useful item. So what I'm going to do... Wait, do I really want to sit here and use the pipe? I guess so. Is we're actually going to go backwards a bit. Now, I don't know if this actually brings back any enemies or not. Or if even at this point, if I can go back. Climb down here. Okay, I wasn't sure if, like, enemies respawned or not. Also, I'm trying to get some of my bearing straight on the controls again. What about the map? Oh! So left on the D-pad, which is between weapons. So is right. There's a map. Okay, I'm going the right way. Basically, I need to kind of go back towards the start of the game. Or rather, the start of the town. Okay, I don't know why I'm hitting the wrong button for a map. So essentially, I need to go back around to the other side. I don't believe there's another way I can get through to where I need to be. So, I'm not going to go into detail about the item I forgot. Can I do anything with this now? Nah. I don't want to go into details about the item I specifically missed, but we're pretty much going to City Hall. Which, if you remember, was kind of right near the statue where I had talked to the judge in that cutscene at the very start. And, for whatever reason, I decided not to go explore that. Yeah, kind of a dumb move on my part, really, but... Again, we're going to see why this is important here in just a minute. First, down the street, take the second left. I don't know if I can go that way. Nope, couldn't go that way anyways, there's no... Oh my. So there are enemies that can attack you, but or within town, but this is pretty much where I'm going. It's not too far out of the way. Okay, come on. There it is. I don't believe there are any monsters here, but there are just... Okay, so we can't hack through the boards. So yeah, there's no specific, like, enemies here that I'm aware of. But it never hurts to have something on hand just in case. We actually have a, and this too, this was technically where the first save point is here at Town Hall. And we have a health drink, always useful. Now the other item I'm looking for, I don't exactly know what room it's in, I just know that it's here somewhere. As in, it's here in Town Hall somewhere. Looks like the last 50 years of Farmer's Almanacs. Each one is perfectly sorted, not a single year is missing. Man, I wish I could go back to the beginning of the season and put some money on the Cubbies. Oh, I'm sorry, that's a sports almanac, but... Come on, when else am I going to get a chance to put a Back to the Future reference in a Silent Hill game? And there's the judge. Hi there.
Hey, Judge Holloway. Can I ask you a question?
Sure, Alex. What is it?
The heck happened to this town?
The town seems empty. All the stores are closed or boarded up. What's going on?
It's complicated, Alex. A lot of things have happened since you left. I really think you ought to just go home.
I noticed a banner out front that said something about an anniversary.
Yes. The town's 150-year anniversary.
But wasn't that celebration, like, years ago? I thought I remembered being here for it.
You're right. Things tend to stay in one place around here. I guess it's... time we took that down, huh?
Was that when all the businesses started closing?
I'm not sure, Alex. It's been a while.
I was just curious.
You need to go home, Alex. Your mother's not been well. She needs you.
What's wrong? Is she okay?
Go home, Alex. Your mother needs you. We can talk later.
Mm-hmm. Gee, it's almost like she's the antagonist. Nothing really in here. Sort of. It's a collection of law encyclopedias and town government papers. There's also a collection of newspapers from the neighboring towns. So anything of interest in here. I'm fairly certain I saw is in Town Hall somewhere. Ooh, it is here. Mom and Judge Holloway talking in our house. So basically they're collectible. I know there's gonna be collectibles that I miss. I'm not too worried about it. And here we got some lore. Sort of, I guess. The history of Shepherd's Glen is one of opportunity and enterprise. First settled nearly a century and a half ago, its founders came here as pilgrims, searching for a new home to practice their faith and ensure the prosperity of their families, of their four families. It soon flourished into a thriving small town. Shops and businesses sprung up on what is now Main Street. The turn of the century brought tourists, eager to explore the region's lakes and rivers, and with tourists came more businesses. In the 1950s, many of the original municipal buildings, such as the town hall and the library, were restored. The 1990s encouraged further investment, modernizing Shepherd's Glen as it headed into the new millennium. But throughout its success, Shepherd's Glen has always managed to remain a close-knit community, maintaining the same ideals on which it was founded. One can only hope that the founding families would be proud if they saw the town as it is today. Sure. When was this book written? That's pretty much it. Okay. This is Cornelius Fitch, another of Shepherd's Glen's four founders. I always forget that Dr. Fitch is his direct descendant. Doc never really liked to talk about town history. Yes, I know, my house. Is this where it came from? Okay, this was the board that I can't use. Off really. I'll swing back out to the front. Okay, I could have swore I saw there was something. See, it's a photo of Shepherd's Glen back when Main Street was still a dirt road. I could have swore there was a specific item. In one of these rooms. Ah, this is like a keyhole. I always thought the symbol was odd. Dad always got angry if I played with this. Okay, yeah, the plate was more for the cemetery, I believe. Okay, I'm gonna go back around in circles real quick because I want to check the other rooms. I could have sworn there's a specific item. I thought it was in Town Hall. So I'm just gonna check all the rooms again. Nothing glowing.
Alex, this isn't really the time. Maybe we can talk later.
Okay, nothing out of the ordinary here. The only reason why I'm looking for this thing is because it's apparently a pretty useful item. And apparently, either I am really missing it, or it's not in this version. Starting to think it's not in this version. Not gonna lie, it is tempting. It is very tempting to look up and see where this item was. May just do that real quick. Because I don't have to come all the way back here just for this one thing. So yeah, I'll be back in just a moment when I try to figure out what I'm missing and where it's at. Okay, so yeah, I'm thinking what I missed is in one of the side rooms. Not this one. Like, it's weird, like, I recognize it when I see it, but I don't recall specifically missing any. That's the judge's room. Yeah, I completely missed this room. That was a whoopsie. So we do have quite a bit of lore here with this. Sort of. It's a newspaper article. What should have been a normal school run home turned into tragedy last week when a freak thunderstorm washed a school bus into the raging torrent of the Toluca River. The normally placid river, swollen by nearly a week of record-breaking rainfall, was running almost 15 feet higher than normal. Mark Ward, the conscientious school bus driver for Toluca County, I can't read today, was unprepared for what he found when entering Riverview Road that runs parallel with the river. The fast-moving water eroded the soil underneath the asphalt, leaving it unsupported. The road suddenly collapsed as the bus pitched into the roaring river below. Carried along a white water ride for a quarter of a mile, amongst the screams of the petrified children, the bus became lodged under the aptly named Hope Bridge. Dr. Martin Fitch, MD, had just finished a house call and was on his way back to the office, following directly behind the school bus when the road gave way. Managing to stop in time, Dr. Fitch got out of his car, braving the downpour, and ran alongside the river for a quarter of a mile when the bus finally became jammed under the bridge. Without a thought for his own personal safety, Dr. Fitch jumped into the river and swam towards the bus. After breaking the rear window, he climbed inside to assess the situation. Inside, he found a terrible scene. The driver, trapped by his safety belt, had been killed when the front of the bus flooded. All of the second and third grade students survived without major injury, but appeared severely frightened by the events. The children were evacuated to the nearby Alcamila Hospital in Silent Hill, oh joy, to recuperate after their ordeal. During the evacuation, the situation took another terrifying turn. His leg trapped by the partially crumpled front of the vehicle, brave 8-year-old Alex Shepard was unable to move. Dr. Fitch knew that if Alex didn't drown, the cold waters of the Toluca River would put him into cold shock as his core temperature plummeted and he succumbed to hypothermia. Time was critical. The doctor quickly stripped off his shirt. Taking a hold of the boy, he wrapped his arms as tightly as he could around him and then waited for the rescue crews to reach them. The heat and warmth of the doctor's body may well have been the only thing that saved Alex's life that day. It took the fire crews nearly 4 hours to finally free Alex from the wreckage of the school bus. During the entire time he was trapped in the bus, Dr. Fitch never left his side. For his feat of bravery, the city council gave him their highest award to Dr. Fitch, along with the key to the city. Though tragedy struck for Martin Ward, the potential loss of all those children was averted by the selfless act of one man, Dr. Martin Fitch, MD. Yeah. I see the thing on the desk. I'll get to that in just a moment. I don't think there's anything else major in here. Looks like a record of the town's obituaries. Attached is a record of burials in Rose Heights Cemetery. Interested in that. The shelves contain medicine and anatomy journals. But the big thing that I saw in the video that I wanted to make sure I get... Whoops, more stuff here. It's a collection of historical books. Famous coal mining towns in New England. Pivotal battles of the Civil War. Frontier cures. Bleed and purge. No, the big thing, though, that I saw was this. I got the serum. So, this is a very interesting item. Now, had I come in here and seen that... and not seen the video, I would have... I'm probably going to use it here in a minute anyways. Once we get back to the cemetery. But the serum is very interesting. Because not only does it completely fill your health to full, it actually extends your health meter. It doesn't extend it by much, or at least gives you more HP. Like, physically, I don't know if the meter actually extends. But apparently it gives you more HP, and there's like 8 of them around the game. Now, had I come to the cemetery, or come to Town Hall, and picked that up, I was thinking it's just like, oh, it's just another... item to be used at some point in the game. Yep. Gate sealed shut. No way I could open it. I have a crowbar. No. This should lead down to the docks as a boat launch. As a kid, I would spend entire summer days out on the lake. Basically, we're probably going to be coming back here later, I'm sure. So yeah, that was a whole bunch of town lore and history of Shepherd's Glen, as well as myself. Yeah, had I found the serum and not seen the video telling what it does, I probably would have never thought to use it. So now we're going to go ahead and make our way back to the cemetery. And actually continue the game proper now. Direction, you can see they have to play a cutscene. This is my first time here. Questions, I don't know if any of the enemies are going to respawn on me. I'll also make sure I'm not missing anything. I have a pipe. Oh. So I don't know how well the pipe's gonna work. I mean, the knife has very short range, but again, it's a lot quicker. Back to the save point area. Save point, I think it's the next one over. Yeah. So definitely go ahead and save here.